light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people.
Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me once again in the Lifer Journal. Our theme for this month is SALOW, salt and light of the world. Today I'm going to be talking about salt. The Bible says that we are the salt of the world, not that we are like the salt of the world, or that we are to act as the salt of the world, but we are the salt of the world. According to Google, 71% of the planet Earth is made out of water. Out of that 71%, 96.5% is salt water. Knowing that water is a major component of life, that definitely lets me know that salt is a major component of life. Salt can be used for many things, actually thousands of things. But I'm gonna mention three or four things that salt can be used for. Salt can be used as a preservative. It can be used as a seasoning. It can be used to actually enhance the flavor of other spices. It's a disinfectant. It can be used to also purify. Our body as a living organism also needs salt to maintain the volume in our bodies. It needs salt to keep its volume stable. Salt is very important. But in order for us to get the best effect from salt, we need to have it in its purest form. For example, today I'm gonna use one of the many salts, the one that we all know about, table salt, the one that we use at home. Right now, this salt is in its purest form. I can trust to really use this to cook, to disinfect, to preserve, expecting the best effect to come from it because it's in its purest form, right? Okay, in order for us to function the way God has called us to be, we have to be in our purest form to give the world the best effect of us, because we are the salt of the world. In order for the world to feel our impact, we need to be in our purest form, right? But it becomes an issue when we're not. Some of us are in our contaminated state. This is salt. It's still salt, but it's salt with some gravel. I think you can hear it. It has gravel, some sand. I got it from the poolside of my apartment. It has sand, gravel. People probably stepped on it. Cats, dogs, name it. I don't know, but I definitely cannot trust to cook with this. I definitely cannot trust to disinfect or to do, you know, to preserve anything with this, because it simply means that whatever I try to use this to cook, it's gonna have gravel, it's gonna have sand, it's gonna have any other impurity that may be in this bottle, is gonna be part of that food. And I have this one, it is salt, it's definitely salt, but it's diluted with water and it also has some gravel in it. I doubt that this salt is gonna have the same saltiness if this water should be sieved out from this container, or if this water should evaporate. This salt is definitely not gonna have the same saltiness as this one. The problem that we have in the Christian body is that we have a lot of people that are salt. They are sons and daughters of God, but they are either in a contaminated state, meaning we are letting things to contaminate our pure nature, our true nature, meaning people living lifestyles that are contrary to the word of God, people living lifestyles or believing things that are not in accordance to the word of God. You are salt, you're still salt, but you're not in your purest form. A person in this state is not capable of giving the world the best that God has put in them. Also, we have people in this state, people that are in a diluted state, lukewarm, Sunday medicine Christians, people with diluted belief state, that have allowed the world to dilute who they are, the programmings of the world to dilute who they are in believing in God. These people don't believe who God has called them to be. These have souls. And this also has salt in it. But out of three of these items, this is the only one that can give the best out of all of them. Today's message is not a matter of whether you are the salt of the world. It's not a matter of whether we are the salt of the world. The Bible has said that we are the salt of the world. The question I have for you today is, are you in your purest form? Thank you so much for joining me once again. Have a great day. Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me once again in the Life Fruit Journal. This month our theme is S.A.L.O.W, Salt and Light of the World. I know you're probably wondering, why is the room dark? It's for a reason. Just for a moment, imagine this room represents the world. I'm gonna turn around the camera and try to pay attention to the things that you can notice, the things that you can't notice. Just try to remember as much as you can as I turn around the camera. Okay, this is what the room looks like when it's dark. This is what the world looks like when it's dark. As the world is dark, like especially this year with all the things that's happening, with politics, with the injustice, with COVID, and not to even mention the individual things that people are dealing with in their lives that can be physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually draining. You never know what people are going through until you talk to someone and actually hear their story. The world is a dark place. And that's why God has called us to be the light of this world. The moment we give our life to Christ, we receive the word of God in us, which gave us light and life. I'm gonna show you what happens when we shine our light. And I'll tell you one of the many ways or the different ways we can actually be the light in our world. Pay attention to the intensity, how the environment changes with each increase in brightness. This is just the first round. You can already see how everywhere lit up. The darkness cannot hold back the light. Just watch. You can see the difference. Okay, I'm gonna run around the room and turn on different lights. Just bear with me. Two more. You can see how everywhere lit up. I'm gonna turn around the camera so you can compare the many things you can see with the things you saw in the beginning. As you can see, you're noticing little details about the room. The colors, the furniture, decoration, how everywhere looks. Okay. This is what happens to the world when we light up our world. Every brightness, every degree of brightness is like each individual shining their light. The moment we give our life to Christ, we receive the word of God, which gave us light and life. And God has called us to be the light of our world. And how do you shine your light to the world? It's by living out the word of God. The Bible says, do not be only hearers of the word, be doers of the word. You living out the word of God in your life, you living out the things that you've seen in the Bible, the instructions of the things that God has asked us to do, or the things he doesn't like us doing, when you actually practice it, you are shining your light to the world. That's what God has called us to do. The darkness cannot hold back light. As you can see what just happened. Are you using your light? Are you living out the word of God? One of the ways is by doing good, helping the poor, feeding the needy, orphans, widows. Like, the Bible gives us the instructions. Someone said that gave an explanation, not explanation, but an abbreviation or an acronym of the Bible. Basic instructions before leaving Earth. It's like it gives you the instructions of the things that you should do before you leave this Earth. Are you shining your light? Shine your light so bright so that the world will see that you belong to God. Thank you so much for joining me once again. Have a blessed day, guys. Bye.